Bill Nye the Science Guy is in favor of evolution because he's a science guy. He should be in favor of evolution. However, he just recently made a video where he criticizes those who believe in creationism and also teach creationism to their children. Let's watch.
Denial of evolution is unique to the United States. I mean, when you have a portion of the population that doesn't believe in that, it holds everybody back, really. Right. So if you try to ignore that, your worldview just becomes crazy. It just untenable, itself inconsistent. And I say to the grown-ups, if you want to deny evolution and live in your world that's completely inconsistent with everything we observe in the universe, that's fine. But don't make your kids do it, because we need them. We need scientifically literate voters and taxpayers.
Okay, obviously we agree with him, right? Mm-hmm. But I just want to note for the record that Bill Nye reminds me of like a less grumpy Dave Kohler.
He's
just as smart, you know, he's a rational guy, but he's not as grumpy as Dave Kohler.
But no one looks more like a scientist than Bill Nye, by the way.
I know, with the bow tie and everything.
If you combined all scientists into one body, that's what you'd have.
Yes. The thought that people who believe in creationism would take a step back and think, maybe I shouldn't brainwash my children with this nonsense, is a little unrealistic. Mm-hmm. I don't think that that's going to happen. In fact, let me give you some numbers that will shock you. This is according to a Gallup poll, and it's a survey of 1,012 adults in May of 2012. 46% of Americans can be described as creationists for believing that God created humans in their present form at some point within the last 10,000 years. How depressing is that?
When I read that, like, I went through the exact same thing that you saw Bill Nye go through on the video, where he's just like, if you want to live in that world, like, he's so disgusted mentally. 46%?
That's a pretty big number.
They think it's more likely that we coexisted with dinosaurs or rode around with angels than we evolved over the course of billions of years, as so many different scientists and different areas of science have confirmed. It's mind-blowing. The reason that they can do that, of course, is that they haven't looked into any of it. They're not interested whatsoever into looking into the science of evolution.
You know, there have been numerous studies that indicate that if you have a firm belief in something and you receive information that conflicts with your belief, you are more likely to take that conflicting information and use it to strengthen your own bias. Mm-hmm. Like, you find a way to put the puzzle pieces together so it'll conform with whatever belief you have.
Yeah.
So in this case, those who believe in creationism will take scientific information like the dinosaurs or, you know, fossils and whatever findings archaeologists are able to find, and they will use that new information to somehow strengthen their own crazy beliefs. It's amazing to me.
Yeah.
And it's because it's human nature to not want to admit that you've been wrong. I mean, think about it. Religion is a big, big part of people's identities. And when you have information that proves your religion wrong or proves that what your religion says existed doesn't really exist, you kind of feel a little foolish. So you try to find a way to say, no. This actually proves my point. It's kind of incredible.
Yeah. No, we've talked about that before. And look, the reason that Bill Nye's coming out and saying this is not just because he has a personal problem with the fact that people are creationists. Is that,
I think he does.
Well, he does too, but that's not the principal reason. The principal reason is that he knows, he understands that our kids are not doing well in college in the life sciences and related areas because they don't either believe in evolution or they're not being taught it regardless of their beliefs because their teachers refuse to teach them. And the thing about evolution is that it works in different scientific areas. You do research based on assumptions that underlie evolution and you get results out of it in the studies of viruses and the creation of medicine and all these different areas that the people who say evolution isn't real don't even know exist. They don't even know that people have careers in that field. They work because of the assumptions that we have about evolution.